There are several types of thunderstorms you will have to be concerned with when it comes to storm spotting. Some of these types of storms are more conducive to heavy rain or hail, while others are more conducive to high winds or tornadoes. One of the more common storms you will see is what we call the single-cell thunderstorm. Typically, there is a low severe weather risk with this type of storm. Usually, it only lasts maybe half an hour to up to an hour. You'll get heavy downpours out of it, some gusty winds, typically on the range of 40 miles an hour or so, and pea to maybe half-inch diameter hail. A multi-cell cluster of thunderstorms is several storms that move together as a single unit. Typically, they'll form along fronts or along outflows from nearby thunderstorms. There is more of an increased severe weather threat with these types of storms. They can produce tornadoes and hail. They can produce damaging winds. However, some of the more common threats are actually with flash flooding and heavy rain. These types of storms tend to move in a line in what we call a training configuration. Here is an example of a downburst that can occur from multi-cell thunderstorms. A downburst is a rain-cooled air mass that rapidly descends in a thunderstorm. In this particular video that was taken last year in West Central Illinois, you can see the downburst coming down from the left side of the screen and then fanning out toward the right as it hits the ground. Severe wind gusts will occur with these types of downbursts. In extreme cases, they can reach 100 miles per hour or higher. Here in Illinois, they typically occur with very heavy rain. They can last several minutes and produce significant wind damage. When you are spotting a downburst, look for the rain foot. This is the curl that occurs on the side of the downburst. It indicates where the strongest winds are located. Typically in a downburst, wind speeds will reach 60 to 80 miles per hour, but as we mentioned before, they can reach 100 miles per hour or greater. Consider that this is the same range of wind speeds that can occur in the lower range of the tornado scales. Note that wind can change direction quickly as the downburst moves through. Here is an example of multi-cell thunderstorms. These storms are moving from the left to the right. You can see that the storms are building on the right side, but then they start to collapse as the storms on the left start to build up. These will move along to the east, then they'll similarly start to collapse, and new storms will form to the west of that. On radar, you can see several clusters of thunderstorms. Typically, in the same situation, the ones on the right will be the ones that are weakening. The ones further to the west are the ones that are building.